Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Raghu here. In this class, we'll discuss about relocatable code in compilers. This class is very important to understand. For understanding this class, our previous class, we discussed an example. Understanding compilers, that example we are using here. Please watch that class and come back here. The link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Coming to the example, what example we have discussed in our last class? So we are going to, our goal is to convert the given high level language into low level language. Machine level instructions should be converted. In order to do that, int a is equal to 2, a is assigned a memory location 510, b is equal to 5, b is assigned a memory location 511, c is given a memory location 512. And these are the instructions for executing of this program. These instructions were discussed in our last class. This is the example which we have discussed. Assume that this is a program and this program is assigned some memory location in random access memory. This is the memory location assigned to this program. So this instructions and data should be saved in this location only. That is what assigned some memory location to the program means. Remaining space is given to P1, P2 like that. Random access memory is filled with different programs. Okay. Now, first we will understand what's the need of relocatable code. Then we are going to understand how we write the relocatable code. Let's try to understand what's the need of relocatable code. Let's take a situation like this. In our computer architecture, we discussed that whenever there is an interrupt from IO, we stop executing this program and give chance to IO program. And in our operating system also, we discussed that if the high priority program has come, we will stop the execution of the present program and give chance to the high priority program. Suppose if that situation happens, what happens here? Let's try to understand. This program is executing. It executed first line, it executed second line, means 2 and 5 is placed in location 510 and 511 location. And this is how the instructions are. So when executing this, a new high priority program has been come to the operating system. So what operating system will do? It will stop executing this program and it will assign execution to the new high priority program. Assume that the random access memory is full. All the programs are filled with random access memory, in the random access memory. So what happens? Operating system has to pick one program from random access memory, save this copy in hard disk. Then after this place should be given to the new program. This is what happens in operating system. So if you do that, suppose if this program has been moved to hard disk and this space is given to the new program, this program space is given to the new program. So new program is copied here and it started execution. After completion of this execution of this new program, again operating system has given chance to this program. Where this program is? This program is in hard disk. From hard disk we have to bring back and copy it in the random access memory, but this place is filled with the new program. So operating system will assign a new space. Assume that the operating system has given space 300 or 200 location, starting location. I am telling only the starting location, 200 location. Then this instruction comes to 200 location. This instruction comes to 201, 202, 203, 204, 205. And this location comes to 210, 211. It starts execution from here. Load DR 510. What's our instruction says? Get the data from 510 location. But the data is in 210 location. This is the problem we are having if you convert the code like this. So that's why we need a relocatable code. So you understand now why we need relocatable codes. How to convert our high level language to relocatable code? Let's try to understand with an example, with the same example. See here. So during the conversion, our compiler or assembler will think that, okay, my program is going to, whatever the program that is going to converted, they will assume that this program is going to store from by default 0th location in random access memory. That is the assumption they will make, and based on that assumption they starts converting the programs. So they assume that this instruction will be saved in 0th memory location in random access memory. This instruction will be saved in first memory location. So on, this goes to 10th memory location, this goes to 11th location, this goes to 12th location. So that's why it has written here store 2 to 10th location, store 5 to 11th location. This is what relocatable code is. Now the responsibility of loader program. We discussed about this loader program in our last class. We have given the name compiler, assembler and loader program. All are responsible in converting this high level language to machine level language. The loader program is going to assign space in memory location, random access memory location. Assume that if the loader program has given the space at 500 location, this loader program is responsible in converting this relocatable code. This is relocatable code. How it is going to convert? This loader program will keep this starting address. What's the starting address? Where it is going to assign this program? In 500 location. The starting address is 500. This 500 is placed in base register. Remember, in computer architecture we are having base register. So if the instruction, if it is, see here, from 500 location it is going to start, store hash to 10, like that the program has been saved here. If it is executing, this 10 is added with this base register. What happens then? This 10, 500 plus 10, to which location it is going to go? 510th location. If the next instruction 11 will be there, 11 will be added to 500, which location it is going to go? 511. This is what relocatable code means. If you write it like this, if the loader program is going to assign this program at 200 location, 10 is added to 200, which location it will be? 210th location. So that we can change this code from one location to other location. During the execution, we can change this code. Suppose in the initially this code is saved in 200 location. After the execution of two lines, computer has changed this location from 200 to 800 location. Yes, it is possible, because of this relocatable code. The responsibility of compiler is to assign the memory space and put it in the base register. The base register value, the base address should be placed here, so that during the execution these values get added with this base value. Then it will go to the exact location. This is what relocatable code means. Hope you understand the concept. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your questions in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates.